Hello, everyone. Today is May 9th, 2022, the week before or of KubeCon. And this is a meeting of the SIG Network Policy API subgroup to SIG Network. This is a CNCF certified meeting. So please be nice to each other and no cursing. And yeah, let's have a good meeting today. So hopping right into more work on the admin network policy API, specifically the semantics of the PR to do that itself. So let me pull up my screen here and we can kind of discuss some of Dan's most recent comments. A lot of nits. I clearly am not that great at proofreading my own spelling, so sorry about that. But I think we can talk about some of the more major things. And he also added something to the agenda about this. So the first one was basically trying to make subject and peer more parallel. This is something that's come up a few times, so maybe we should brainstorm it a little bit more. So let's find his comment.
Wait. What does it mean by making subject and peer more parallel?
So basically, like, there's a little bit of overlap in the API itself regarding, right? Like selecting a subject for an admin network policy is different from selecting a peer for a number of reasons. And so we've defined that as such as various different types within the API. And he's saying, like, can we explore maybe creating an overlap in the sense of, can we share types between the two? I believe that's what he's saying. This stems from kind of his dislike of basically how stuff works. It looks when you write it in YAML. And I kind of tend to agree. I hadn't taken the time to sit down and kind of write this out, but with today's design currently, like, this is fairly ugly, right? At the end of the day. Like, I think this is where he's coming from, but I'm not 100% sure.
Wait. So the last one, the one you're highlighting right now, I don't think our spec would look something like that, right? Why would that be two pods there?
Because we ended up changing something that was named pod selector to just pods.
Right. And there's also a pod selector down there. So it's pod selector. So it feels like three levels of nesting. I don't think that's the case.
Let's go look. I have the PR. I have the actual API up.
Right.
And also, I feel like under pods, there will be namespace selector as well, right? So that's probably why we had a prefix pod.
Right.
I think we have a new folk here. Maybe let's just say hi first.
Yeah, for sure. Let me get back to my actual terminal where I can see all of y'all. Oh my gosh. Okay. Well, let me pause share. There it is. Awesome. Hey, Sir Gang, how's it going? You might be on mute, but so we've kind of been dying.
I think Shugang is from my team as well. So yeah. He's from Google and works on network security, cool. Like me and Rahul.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, Shugang is. Shugang, do you want to unmute yourself and talk? Yeah, just ask him. I mean, he literally sits next to me.
Hey. Yeah, just have some audio issue.
Or is it all?
Yeah, do you want to give us just a little intro, Shugang, and then talk about why you're here? I know you're on his team, but there might be some more to add.
Hi, my name is Sugal. I work with Satish, right, in the same team. And we both also working on GKE network policy related stuff.
Cool. Awesome. Well, great to have you. We currently are kind of running through the admin network policy API that we're implementing. And if you look in the agenda, there's some links to the KEP, which we'll describe it more, and the actual PR we're looking at today. So feel free to follow along.
Yep.
Thanks. Okay. Hey, Dan, we were just talking about some of your comments.
Yeah, I added a few things to the agenda. Yep.
This one. Yep, we were going on the first one. So talking about basically trying to make subject and peer more parallel. We looked at this and we were just, Yang wanted to verify that this is actually what would happen, like this double nesting of pods. I think when I looked just before this meeting, like it could happen. So we just wanted to look really quick at the actual code. So, right, if we have a, if we've got a defined peer, the first layer is pods, right, Yang?
Right. Yes, and then if you go to namespace pod peer.
It's pods again. We have like another layer of indirection, right? Because so when we initially designed this, we thought, okay, we might one day add more ways to select pods, right?
Right. So I'm just wondering why it's pods down there. Shouldn't it be just a pod selector? What is pod peer though?
I commented on this, like I think my next comment on the thing, like pod peer doesn't seem like it's needed. Like if we were going to add a new way to select pods, like, you know, service selector or whatever, mm-hmm. that should be a new option underneath
I agree. This is wrong. So I feel like under, if you scroll down to namespace pod peer, mm-hmm. I think it should have namespaces with namespace peer is fine because you will have all the self not same label stuff under there, right? But for the second one, it should just be pod selector. It shouldn't be another level of nesting. That doesn't really make sense.
Yep, agreed. I will change that for sure. So that was the one part of it. The other part was Dan was kind of arguing or saying we should combine some of.
Right, right. On that note, I think we had this conversation before, if I remember this correctly, with Tim and the other guys, and the reason why we decided to go with separate fields is that, you know, for the subjects, something doesn't really make sense. So when you select subjects, you are really clear on, you know, which labeled namespaces you want to select or which labeled pods you want to select. But in that particular case, you cannot basically say something like, I want to select subject and the namespace is from self. That doesn't really make sense because you need to select subject first. And then in the peers, you can say, I wanted to select namespaces from self. So there are some inherent differences between the subject and the peers. And, you know, we didn't want to sort of like mix those two types together. Because otherwise you will have, you know, other weird stuff, like, you know, validations. You want to say that if it's appearing in the subject field, and you want to verify that the namespace equals self, not self, is not set because it cannot basically be there.
Yeah, no, so I wasn't saying that they should literally be the same types, but like, Andrew, if you go back to the comment on the PR, I showed one thing where like the top half of the comment, like right now, you know, the subject for subject and for a peer are exactly the same, except there's one extra level in the peer. And I feel like, you know, we could just add that to subject as well, even though it's not necessary. And, you know, would that make it easier for people to use if, you know, if they were the same rather than, you know, getting rid of it because it's the only option in the subject. I wasn't sure.
I see what you mean. So you want to sort of like let people have the consistency by, if they wanted to select something by labels, there's always going to be four lines sort of thing. Is that?
Yeah, basically. Like, yeah,
okay.
It just seems like it could possibly be a little confusing the way it is now, and that might make it clearer.
Yeah, and this is the only place we don't have like a level of indirection for selecting something, right? This field. Okay. Yes. I'm not against it. I mean, it would literally just be another type that's wrapping a namespace selector, a label selector, but.
And it's possible that you had one before and I convinced you to get rid of it last time.
I'm pretty sure that's exactly what happened. I think I started out with that and we were like, oh wait, we don't need that. but that is a long, that's what happens with longstanding rounds of reviews.
So I'm not sure if the two pod versions are exactly the same once you get rid of the extra level of pods. I think they're pretty close.
Pods, it's just like, it's the naming is slightly different. I'll write out some YAMLs, I think, after this round of reviews, and then we can look.
Yeah.
But I think it applies to pod as well, if I understand correctly, because for the subject there are no multiple selectors. For peer we have multiple selectors because we do have a pod selector, selecting the constructs within the cluster versus selecting outside the cluster. So that's why we added additional indirection. Is that correct?
The additional indirection was all for extensibility, like in the future, just to make it a little bit more explicit and easier. And it's just kind of the API design syntax that Tim is advocating for. I think we've all kind of agreed on. What Dan's saying basically is like, we just have one less layer of indirection and everywhere else we have it. So it's kind of confusing to write the YAML for it.
Actually, I wanted to add in here. So I think you were asking the question if the namespace pod subject is really close to namespace pod peer. And the answer is no, because in namespace pod peer, you will have the namespaces struct where you can do same labels, not same labels, etc. But in the namespace pod subject, there's only a namespace vector. And if continue on your argument before, if you do a namespace selector here, it's also one less indirection for the selectors, because if you wanted to write a namespace pod, both selectors in the subject case and in the peer case, in the subject case, you will have one less line, if you will, if that makes sense.
Yeah, I think, that's what I wanted to make. Yeah, because the subject will always have one less indirection than the...
Right. Because it doesn't have the same self, not self thing. So, right.
Okay. As an action item, I will make that consistent in terms of nesting, and then also remove the deepest pod peer indirection layer we have that we don't need. And then I think after this round of reviews, I'd like to just write some YAMLs, maybe some real life YAMLs, and try to see like if there's anything we're missing.
Yeah, there's actually a third thing in the second example there. In the namespace case, the namespace selector is called just selector, whereas in the pod case, the pod selector is called pod selector. Again, that seems like sort of a...
The problem is that in the namespace and pod peer, there can be two types of selectors.
Right. So I think I was saying, it looks like I was saying that the one that's just selector here should be namespace selector.
Right.
And again, you know, maybe I'm the one who argued against that before. I think you're right, Andrew. I think you need to like we need to come up with some example objects so that we can get a feel for how they look.
No, you know what? You were the one who argued against that before, because I had everything super explicit, like obscenely explicit. Like even if it was in a namespace peer, I had it as a namespace selector. But yeah,
okay.
But I will write it out. I think that's the best way to see
it. Can we go back to the comment real quick? I just wanted to. So pods.
So you're right. I did say here, why not change pod selector to selector? But yeah, obviously that can't be because there are two selectors there. So
wait, so did we say that if a namespaced it's a namespace pod peer and you say pods blah blah blah, you can omit namespace vector in that case? Is namespace selector required in this case or no?
Let's see, I think it is.
So the pod peer.
Namespace pod peer.
Right, so that's, I think that's where I'm confused about. Essentially, if you specify namespace pod peer, you need to both provide namespaces and pod selector. So that might make it a little bit more unclear, because if you say, in the example if you go back to the comment, so essentially you cannot do that if we just get rid of the extra level of pods, right so it's from then pods, and then along with a select pod selector you will have to provide a namespace. That may make it look a little bit more clear. Because if you just say selector and you provide namespaces down there, it might be a little bit confusing.
I see what you're saying. Because it's gonna say pods,
and then
namespaces,
and then a selector down there, and you're not knowing whether it's selecting pods or namespaces. That's what.
No. I mean, if we get to this scenario, right?
Mm-hmm.
We are coming from admin network policy peer, and then we'd basically say pods. I think it'd be confusing because we'd say pods, but you're saying if we get rid of that level of indirection, right? That's why we did it in the beginning, because you're saying if this was just a pod selector, like this would end up just being selector. Right, but it has to be pod selectors for us. Okay.
Right. I'm arguing for it needs to be pod selector. If you just say selector here, it makes it a little bit more confusing.
Yeah, but then this need, well, then we don't have this level of under, this is all gone, pod peer.
Yeah. For this one, I think I was probably more arguing that the selector in the namespace struct should be namespace selector, not selector.
Yeah.
But again, like let's see some objects, and then we can argue.
Agreed. 100%. Sorry, I'm just taking some notes.
Side note, are you in Spain already then?
Am I in Spain?
Yeah.
No, I... Thursday night.
Oh, cool.
Was anyone else here going?
I wish.
I wish too. I really wish I was going, to be honest. But no, I don't think anyone else was. It was just you and Tim. Hopefully we'll be at the next one. Okay, I will do that. Writing out a couple examples will be awesome. And we're gonna have to do it anyway, and we're almost to a T of equalization, so I shouldn't have to redo it a bunch of times. We talked about pod peer. I'm gonna clean up this, because at the end of the day, like we need to do whatever it takes to make these YAMLs look readable. Like it's pointless for us to make an API that has stuff like that in it.
I don't know. Network policy is pretty bad in places and people use that. So
Yeah, fair enough. Well, that's the scariest part about all this is even if we crank out a great API, it's going to be super confusing to transition. But all we can do is have user guides and suggest things. Was that what else? So the other comment you had, Dan, was also namespace only rules versus namespace and pod rules. Did we already cover that or did you have something else to add there?
Yeah, I think that was all just part of that.
Okay, cool. I've already gone through, thanks for catching a lot of these. There was a lot of nits. I'm sorry about that. I've looked at this so much that I don't think I can see anything anymore. I think I addressed most of these already locally. This was one I was going to ask you about. You're saying basically reusing the admin network policy status struct for both seems out of sorts, but I was trying to think of a actual reason for creating, you know, an admin network policy status struct and a baseline admin network policy status struct. Like, are they ever going to be different, or is it just a purely reading through the code? You have a problem with
that? Yeah, they'll probably be the same, but it just feels wrong to not have its own completely identical copy.
So why can't it just be a list? Like, why can't we just not have a type for that and it just be a list of conditions?
Because we may want to add more status fields later.
Okay. Okay, that's, if no one
else. And having status be a struct is an API convention. Like, yeah. Things assume that.
Okay, I'll change that. Yeah, I think everything else was pretty straightforward besides this. So I will clean up what we have and push some changes here later today and start writing some YAMLs. I mean, we should have a list of YAMLs anyway, just as reference to be probably put in this repo as well. So that'll be good. Any other comments or questions with admin network policy bits? After I finish these changes, is the next step just to get, so once we have the LGTM from you, Dan, I still think we'll wait for the LGTM from Tim, right, before merging, or is it sort of like if we get one, just go ahead and merge? Like, what do you think?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's alpha one, right? Like, if it's not like, And this is merging to our own repo, right?
Right, right. We own.
So yeah, if people will probably find bugs as they start implementing it anyway, right? So, you know, this isn't absolutely the end. You know, if there's something Tim wants changed after you merge it, then it can be changed after you merge it.
Okay, cool. I know we really don't have any protocols set up yet for this, you know, org, and this is such a small subgroup. All of a sudden it used to be a little bit bigger, I think. So I just wanted to make sure we weren't doing anything out of whack. The next step, I think, for, you know, in terms of work items that I would definitely need some help with after getting this merged, is I'd like to copy sort of the doc setup the Gateway API has, and we can start, it's going to be a long road, but I'd like to start getting some docs put together while all this is fresh in our heads. Because it's going to be really important to have good documentation for this API. And it'll be good for the implementers, which I feel like are going to be basically the folks in this room right now. So at least the first round of implementers. Are you going to implement this for SDN, Dan, or should I just do it for OvenK?
I will probably not implement it for OpenShift SDN.
Cool. Okay. Well, we'll do it for OvenK then. Any other questions, comments, concerns? I have a PR up adding Yang as an owner for this. I might do the same for you, Dan, if that's something you would like. We definitely need to add you to the contributors list for this because you've been super incremental here. Yeah, that's all I have. I will poke the group when I have the rest of this done. And if we could just get some final read-throughs and LGTMs. We can move forward from there. If not, keep working. But I think we can go ahead and give everyone some time back today. And yeah, feel free to reach out on Slack. I really appreciate it. Hope you all have a good day.
All right. Bye.
Thanks. Bye.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye.